Got it, sir? You got it. You can start. 4 minutes is there. You can.
How many people are attending? How many people?
Participants.
The participants.
Sure.
After we join, karo bhai.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Madam, ek mein chahiye, do mein karo bhai. You join from your device. Madam.
मोबाइल से डरो ना भाई, मेरे को काम होता है मोबाइल से, मोबाइल से
दादी बात नको करो भाई, जितना बोला उतना करो।
अरे तुम मैं क्या बोलूं,
तो मैं क्या बोला भाई, मोबाइल से करो।
स्टॉप इट इमरान,
मैं तो गुस्सा में चुप कर दे।
थैंक यू
भाई,
थैंक यू
It's already started, sir.
You can mute. I know you just ask again.
Sir, unmute yourself. You have muted yourself.
Mute all of the sare ekoti. So main host.
लाइट चेंज कैसा कर लेंगे? नेक्स्ट बोलना पड़ेगा।
You say next, sir. I will change.
You'll just give any signal, she will change.
So, participants will change. Yes,
kitchen.
Can you start?
Just wait for one moment. It very few are there.
Good afternoon, everybody. We will start in a minute. Let more people join. Echo aa raha hai.
No, volume better. No volume. Thank you.
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबडी. इट इज माई वॉइस इज क्लियर टू एवरीबडी. ओके, सो टूडे वी आर हैविंग ए वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट वेबिनार वेर सक्सेसफुल एंड मैनी अदर एंटरप्रेन्योर्स दे डोंट बॉदर फॉर दिस इज सक्सेशन प्लानिंग फॉर SME. See, there are indications. One survey says the average life of MSME in India is 8 years, and another survey says 1 in 10,000 MSME goes beyond 10 years. So this should ring a alarming bell. Okay, this is indicating okay, some of the things what our entrepreneurs are doing may not be right. This indicates, apart from various reasons, one critical point is a succession of MSME units get very little attention from MSME entrepreneurs. Generally, all the entrepreneurs in the age group of 25 and 40 work very hard to create customers for their product services, establish teams and compliances with regulation, regulators, etc., and generate profit. This does not mean that this is covering larger group for entrepreneurs. He also creates intangible assets beyond the balance sheet. This is one of the critical factor. They say goodwill, this thing, and intangible assets are in many ways, like your brand, like your goodwill in the market, suppliers' credit, customers' good reputation. All that is a part of intangible assets. Your team is also a very big part of a intangible asset, which every entrepreneur generates in the process of first 5 to 10 years, and then go on expanding on that basis. Entrepreneurs love his company operations. See, this is generally entrepreneurs love his company's operation, but are not as good as the business side of the things, which means they struggle to lead employees and feel like the business runs you more than you run the business. He is stuck in a daily operations. Maybe he has not taken much time to look ahead for or consider putting a building block in place for succession planning. This is very critical. And later on my slides, it will come generally when you should start. Most entrepreneurs want to see their business survive post themselves, but are not sure how to make that happen. Most of the entrepreneurs, mere baad mein mera beta samalega, mera bhai samalega, that kind of things they have got in mind, but they don't put it on proper format. And when he leaves the company for some reasons, or he is no more, then this becomes a very big challenge. Most entrepreneurs want the security of their families after them, and they should plan for succession at least 5 to 10 years ahead to give definitive directions continually. This is very critical. Generally, time will be 5 to 10 years, but as you start much earlier, it will give definitely a lot of advantage. Generally, entrepreneurs' mindset is the biggest change. The reality of facing succession is probably the most important and hardest hurdle for entrepreneurs. He feels that he is going to be eternal. Yeah, but generally, it does not happen. It will be difficult to think about someone able to someone else running the business where he has put all his blood, sweat, and tears. Many times, entrepreneurs go all through this, which is not in the side of the balance sheet. He wants a clone of himself in the ideal case scenario. Accepting the reality that succession is a must once the business is established some strength of the entrepreneur is not required. So, see, when a young entrepreneur starts, he has got certain strength. But after some maturity, his team can take over most of the things. But he is, then his requirement, the same strength what he has started with may not be required for the same thing. It means multiple people taking the reins of the business is a possible solution. Succession planning allows the business to address holes in the entrepreneur's strength and create a path to fill these holes. This is very critical for any entrepreneur. The starting point will be to have a deep look at business and defining what the future should look like. So we are in a dynamic world. We are in a dynamic world, and every hour, every minute, every second, things around us changes, and that affects the business. So he should be able to predict the probable future of his business to take a rational decisions how to move further. This requires the same mindset of how you behaved when you started your business. So when you started your business, you got a different mindset. See, like Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. So when you start, you create something, Brahma. And Vishnu, when you maintain it like that, success and requires entrepreneurs to be creative, try new things and fail. This is again a big challenge. No entrepreneur would like to experiment and fail. But if he takes a controlled experimentation, he will be able to give a new jerk to his business and all of his planning. Succession planning is now, succession goal is the criteria. Why do you want a succession goal? Entrepreneurs have got a choice between fast, good, and cheap solutions. When thinking of succession planning, you can at most pick two of these, that is fast, good, and cheap. All the three you cannot get in this thing. Large value encashment by selling the business. Today, Just Dial has practically done that, selling that business and retaining Mr. Money continued in the transition as a MD for a few more years. So that whatever that continuation will come to Just Dial. Control or a speedy succession transition, that is a required thing for many entrepreneurs in a different age group. Succession planning requires at least 10 years to make the plan in reality. Early planning gives the owner more flexibility to tailor a business succession plan that allows to remain with the enterprise in a capacity he or she chooses for as long as he or she desires. Apollo Hospital or HCL Technologies are an ideal example. When they have taken a succession planning much earlier, they are able to put their children. Roshni has come in HCL, or three girls, or of Dr. Reddy has been groomed for last about 8-10 years for a easy transition of success, succession. And many families are doing that much earlier so that they can select. Mukesh Ambani is also trying to groom his three children in succession. Like that, many corporate sector, why not MSME? So the calendar is very critical. Succession planning for SME businesses is important for several reasons. The benefit of a business succession plan benefits the owner, the company, and the succession owners so that he can guide. It also benefits customers and clients. This is very important. It is it also benefit customers and client by ensuring that the company will go through a stable transition, which enables the company to continue providing the goods and services that customer and clients require for many years. Benefits of SME business success plan include, but are not limited to, stable and smooth transition of the company when the time comes. Maximize the value you receive for your company if you transfer the company to a third party or liquidate the company. You see, many small businesses in Raniganj and RP Road, which are from my family members, have closed down. And because they were knowing that they will have to close the business, they have encased the total stock much earlier. We're going to the office, continuing the office, so that they can get maximum value. Maintain your lifestyle during your retirement. Choose how to exit the business includes creating one or more roles for yourself to continue working for the company after transitioning the company to a new owner. Provide for your family's financial stability and future. Choose and train successor for the company. Create a plan to liquidate or transfer the company if it becomes necessary. Create roles for family members within the company. Today, Kirloskar is a big brand, and three brothers have gone to Supreme Court various reasons. 138 companies, this is the problem today they are facing. Identify any weakness within the company and prepare a plan to remedy those issues now. Identify key employees and develop a plan to retain those employees after the transfer. Prepare to handle unexpected events. Determine the legal documentation and financial tool necessary to carry out your business succession plan. After completing your business succession plan, remember to review your plan regularly. Business, industry, and life changes necessitate the changes to your succession plan. Many of us who are in the age group of 60 and above are preparing our will, and every 2-3 years we try to change that will according to the dynamics of the family life what we are going through. Similarly, succession plan also has to be reviewed regularly and take the changes which has happened in external and internal environment. Then the big question is, how do you plan a business succession? So that is a big question. Many entrepreneurs don't know. So the first step in developing a business succession plan is to think about what you want to do with your business when you exit. Discuss your thoughts with close family members who may be affected by the transition. Your decision could have a significant impact on your family. So this, see, your family is also critical. So this point you have to take care when you plan and discuss with them will be preparing them to prepare themselves for any eventuality. It can also be helpful to spend time identifying your personal and financial short-term and long-term goals. These goals can help guide you as you determine a path for your company with and without you at its helm. SME succession planning best practices. It will be beneficial to review all options when you develop when developing a business succession plan. Typically, SME entrepreneurs have 5 options for existing their business are as follows: transfer the business to a family member or family members, sell the company to a key employee or business partner, sell the company to an outside purchaser, close and liquidate. IPO route, which is explained later. I'll come back to IPO route. These are generally five practices which are existing in the ecosystem today. And you will have to tailor your own goals, long-term, short-term, family members, and other restrictions while you plan it out. Start with business valuation. See, in foreign countries like America, Australia, you get a business valuer. Unfortunately, we don't have that ecosystem well defined. And if it is available, it is very costly for a MSME entrepreneur. So when you want to start succession planning, you have to start with a valuation of existing business. Unfortunately, this does not have, in India, we don't have defined valuation process. Business succession planning checklist. I am now going to give you succession planning for a small business owner's checklist. You can see this will be available later in the video form. So you can send a request to us so that we'll give you that recording. A checklist of matters to be addressed when developing a business succession plan includes list of your short-term and long-term goals for your company, your personal finances, and your personal life. A list of potential successors, including description of each successor's strength and weakness. A timetable for various events and the succession. A list of potential options for exiting the business, including descriptions of each option's strengths and weaknesses. A standard operating procedure for the company, such as a copy of employees. Copy of the employee's handbook, company policies, procedures, manuals, etc. This is very critical, preparing a SOP for a successful handing over, because this will give your employees and company to have a standard set of procedures so that any hiccup, larger decision only will come to that. Routine things will continue with the employees if somebody else is coming in. Formal business valuation by a business valuer. Description of key employees, officers, and managers and their roles and duties. Potential solution and option for financing the transfer of the company to another owner. Analyze of tax consequences of each transfer option. When you do general this thing, you miss this point. What will happen to your tax liabilities? When in case you are no more, or you are transferring easily, so that tax implication, you can take the advice from my good friend Mr. Hanumanthulu, like people are there who can guide you for all this. After addressing the various matters and issue related to transferring of existing or exiting the your business, you can develop a detailed business succession plan based on the option you choose for exiting the company. Most comprehensive succession plan include sections which alternative plans if something occurs that renders the preferred succession plan impracticable or unfeasible. Then last point in this thing is one possible route is IPO route. Many SME units have crossed 10 crores and has got potential to reach 20-30 crores in next few years. Many entrepreneurs must have taken 10 to 20 years to reach and may have accelerated growth in last few years as he has got customer base, team, and some system which can be upgraded. See, I find that many entrepreneurs don't want to dilute their stacks. I'll come to that later. For these entrepreneurs, value unlocking by going to stock exchange to raise money, equity type for growth, which creates borrowing capacity because of better debt equity ratio. Most important is to attract better talent to take the company to the next level of growth. This is very critical, whether you get money or not, but attracting the talent. Talent is nowadays becoming very scarce resources, and it takes many years to develop a tailor-made talent. Most entrepreneurs worry for losing controls and follow corporate governance and MCA rules. Many are afraid, भाई ये चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट को लाना पड़ेगा, कंपनी सेक्रेटरी करना पड़ेगा, बहुत कंप्लायंस हो जाता है. बट इट इज नॉट सो फॉर द ईज ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ योर राइट्स. बट ही हैज टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ही मे बी एबल टू रेज फंड्स एट ए प्रीमियम विच विल रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ऑफ फंड्स. टूडे जोमेटो making 2,300-2,400 crore this thing, the today public issues are oversubscribed by 39 to 40 times. What does it indicate? There is a dearth of good possible long term business upsides. So Zomato, Paytm, all that are coming in near future for IPO. And the rate of oversubscription is indicating. So that you, if you have developed a good system and good brand image, you will be able to encash at a very high this thing. All your intangibles like brand image, team, performance, all that will be calculated and bring it into intangible asset valuation, which can be unlocked by pricing your issue at a premium wherever it is possible. Here one flexibility is there is to be emotionally connected. See, till you desire as a board member, so company you have created will live or grow with your guidance. So see, like now Rahul Bajaj of Bajaj Auto is 84. In last 5-7 years, he has gradually released this thing, but he has become a chairman and then ex-chairman like that. So the emotional impact of his own valuable suggestions to the company will always be available to the board member and other things. Rahul Bajaj is only one in the case. In our case, we are the entrepreneurs. We have created the value. We would like to see that after us, our family members and our key employees get benefit. So this is a very good this thing. We SME will help you to inspire and help you to start the process. See, we have got a team of 4 or 5 people, like my good friend Sarkar sir is there, Sudhakar sir is there, Srinivas is there. So they can we can as a team help you to sit with you, work out that what are the possible ways you can look into. I request you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we are coming on every Saturday wherever possible to come out with an important topic which affects the performance of MSME unit. My personal belief is that the entrepreneur has got much more potentiality than he himself knows about it. So my suggestion will be to subscribe to our YouTube channel. These are my other coordinates where you can connect with me anytime. Thank you. And I'll welcome the questions now from the... Where is the question? So can I request people to ask questions? Better question bolna. I think my good friend has suggested increasing the valuation through creation of intangible and professional management is key to success and planning. Am I right? Yes, sir. Sarkar ji, you being a chartered accountant, you are always right. But See, when in MSME, emotional attachment and emotional sacrifice is what an entrepreneur has done, has also to be considered, which will be off the balance sheet item, and that can be only factored by various things. Hanumanthu Sahib has said, entrepreneur need to allow, accept, adopt the procedure required. Sir, this all can be possible only once they realize that they are not eternal. See, we think that somebody else is going to die, we are not going to die, or we will not be handicapped. That is not right. So at a right time, you should see that you start doing, start taking action earlier. Hanumanthu Sahib has suggested, instead of closing the business, it can be sold to others as a going concern. Yes, sir, you are right that continuation of business will help the customer, employees from uncertainties. But here in India, as on today, we don't have a standard valuation procedure or valuer who are reliable in a smaller companies. And then ultimately, they don't have a choice of transfer of the business. And in my age group, children have gone to foreign countries. So when they come, when we are no more, they come here to complete the burying and other things. And their cost of money is so high that they would like to leave 5-10 lakhs of rupees, 20 lakhs of rupees, and see that they settle the issue and go back faster so that they can recoup the money. But wherever it is possible, that option should be planned and implemented in stage-wise with a close coordination with second in command or third in command. It will help the continuity of business. Otherwise, that intangible assets, I have seen thousands of small companies getting closed, which are a very good local brand value. And people like us who have seen them dying will say, ki bhaiya chal sakta tha, nahi chala hai, ye mistake kiya, ye mistake kiya. That is why I have come out with this topic, because many of MSME, they think that they are going to live 100 years or 200 years. Unless until they plan, it will not be possible to this thing. Hanumanthu Sahib, you are very right. There is a scope for improvement at every stage. Outside consultant with expertise, experience can guide better. But who has to move first? The entrepreneur has to first realize and then go to consultant like you, who selflessly can guide them. And then at appropriate stage, the initial breakthrough or thinking process improvement, entrepreneur will have to go through. And if he start adopting small improvement as suggested by many of my learned friends who are there today in my webinar, it will definitely add much higher value than entrepreneur thinks. But entrepreneur in the fear, it will cost me a bomb, just don't move out. I don't know how to create that ecosystem where entrepreneurs get free consultation for 1 hour or something, and then he can come out with a better idea. See, my effort in creating this, it took me a long time to work out whether it is important for MSME entrepreneurs or not. Because when I was an entrepreneur, I thought my two children, one become engineer and one will become chartered accountant, and my unit will run eternally. But that could not happen. See, financially, as a family, we will be rich. But the 150 people who were working with me has gone. So these are the costs. How succession planning can be successful for a small business when there is no much growth. sir, whosoever has asked, he has not put his name. You first understand you are not going to be eternal. So small business or growth is not there. People like Hanumant Lu, Sarkar, or many other people like our team can help you why your business is not growing. That is one item. But success, success and planning is a continuous ongoing process. So please don't stop thinking. Okay. My good friend has said that he is ready to give a free consultation. So please take his services wherever it is required. Hanumantu sir, can you give your mobile number or email address so that they can contact you, or they can contact me? I will give that detail. Sarkar is asking, external consultant can surely help, but it requires a change in entrepreneur's mindset. The entry has to be convinced that professional management can build value to the business growth. You are right, Sarkarji, but you should understand the development ecosystem of MSME development from early 60s and 70s. There is a considerable change in today's entrepreneur, but still they requiring a lot of mentoring. They require a roadmap to be prepared. And I don't think India is a very unsaturated market. So they have got a lot of potentiality to grow. It's a mindset which stops your own growth. Manjula CH, are people ready to take free consultation, sir? Yes, this is another problem. We are not Google. We are not Google. So Google everybody will use, but then either consultant will have to create that kind of mindset so that anybody can come for free consultation for half an hour or something, and then realize that what are these changes he can make. See, there are people. We don't have to go to Nani Palkiwala or many other high level professionals. My CA friends, roughly 3 lakh CAs are available all over India. So if you see any CA above 45, 50, he will be in the process to give something back to society. So most of the CAs, when they are open, they can give you these things. So please don't think that CAs are only working for money. They are also ready to give back to society. Few like my Hanumant Lu friend, sir, or Sarkar ji, or many, because there are various possibilities where he has to make money. He will make his money, but not immediately, and he will not overcharge also. That much also I can assure you, because Hanumant Lu, Sarkar, I know personally. Srinivas ji, food processing policy detail. I would like to share it, but it has just come about 2 or 3 days back. So I will have to study that and work on that. Questions? Srinivasji, we can connect one-to-one for further discussion. Any further questions? I thought it will be very highly interactive, because succession planning, probably first time in this part of the city or this part of Telangana or South, somebody is coming out with first time. Manjula, Hanumant Lu sir can always help any young entrepreneur, and he is always very critical that restrict yourself for not taking much debt in the initial stages, and that has helped whosoever has heard his advice or followed his advice. They are reasonably successful, including his own. he has also this thing. So he is against debt, definitely, because debt, he has got his own reasoning. People like this thing, Hanumanthu sir has given his mobile number. Everybody can note down and help themselves. Manjula, whether CA is the only person who will help entrepreneurs or any other professionals are there? See, your own parents, your own cousin brothers or cousin uncles, they can help you, but they can give you a confused signal. If you take advice from any professionals, see, I expect that India will be ready for business consultant in next few years. It has started coming for larger companies. It will come down to smaller companies as the business grows. So definitely there will be a second cadre coming up, expert with expertise on business valuation. I know one Mr. Moksha. When he said about 4 years back, he can give a valuation to intangible companies. Intangible assets of any company. I was surprised what kind of formulas are there. But with level of education going up, many more people like Moksha will come out and may be able to help you. Global Tree, sir, any new scheme came into the light for service industry for procuring loans? Sir, if my good friend Hanumanthu is there, when he sees this thing, he will also say that why did you encourage when you know that loans are not this thing. Loans are like this. When you take out your morning toothpaste from the toothpaste and put it on the brush, theoretically it can go back, but it will not go back. Normal method. So try to avoid taking loans in the early stage of the business. Stabilize your business where it can become sustainable, and then think. Lot of chartered accountants are there in my webinar, and they will tell this also only. Somebody has asked, can you explain liquidate clearly? I told that in Raniganj or in RP Road, when their children have gone away to foreign countries, they are only planning to close the business because it is uneconomical for those children to come back. And they have not created a second rating of the people. In Australia, my uncle was doing this travel business. And one of his key employees has developed and he sold his unit at $500,000 to be recovered in 3 to 4 years till he is alive. And that has gone on very well. That kind of facilities or people are not open here because they see that brand image of that Da Center Travels still continues. It is 30 years old company. Where do you get a 30 years old brand image? It has got existing customers and good relation with airlines. So that is why continuity and identifying earlier successor will help you. That too, Swami sir. Now I'm 22 years old. How to become a successful entrepreneur? Very good question, though it is not connected here in this topic. But to become a successful entrepreneur, first thing, crystallize your idea. Don't consider miss n number of ideas will come to you. Write down in this thing, mull over, sit over, and then do. You people are aware of how to use Google or how to use various websites. And collect the data and discuss with people like us so that they can always handle you to go to next stage. In my personal life also, I have handled many people. External civil services are provided which entrepreneurs can avail of. Yes, Sarkar ji, external CFO, but still that price barrier, CFO will be asking too much money. I don't know how to break. Hanumantu sir is there or you are there, because this is required for a unit which I have suggested for 10 to 10 crores in IPO route. Because when IPO, you get your shares. So you don't have to sell the unit which you have created. You encash the premium. And if you perform better, that value goes up. So anytime something even happens to you, you will be able to encash, or your family members will be able to encash that this thing. And somebody else can take it. Like Reliance has taken Just Dial today. The process, that is a corporate buyout, but in MSME also it will happen in between listed companies. There are 600 or 800 listed companies on NSE and BSE for on emerge platform, small companies. Somebody, sir, can Mr. Hanumantu speak to that? We will be happy to listen from his word. Sir Hanumantu, sir, are you ready to talk? This friend of us is asking. Hanumantu sir, can you give him access?
Yes, sir. I'm ready.
Sir, please ready. Help this gentleman.
Sir, I'm ready to speak. And also, yeah. I'm thankful for giving me this platform to express my opinions.
Sir, we are supporting MSME for last many years. Let us keep doing that good work.
Definitely,
thank you.
Definitely will continue to do that work.
Sir, Hanumantu sir has agreed and he will join. Usko access de diya wo photo batao, photo bhi.
Hello.
Haan sir, one minute. See, I am a technological poor man.
आप भी अपडेट करना पड़ता
है सर. नहीं वो हमारी क्या बोलते हैं, आई एम होस्ट इज डूइंग दैट. सर यू कैन गो अहेड. आई थिंक योर पिक्चर विल कम लिटिल. आई डोंट नो हाउ इट विल कम, बट यू कैन टॉक टू दिस जेंटलमैन.
थैंक्स फॉर गिविंग द प्लेटफॉर्म.
यू कैन इवन टॉक इन तेलुगु इफ देयर कैन. यस, योर पिक्चर हैज कम.
Yes.
Sir, please go ahead and talk to Hanumantu.
Thanks for giving me this opportunity to express my opinion or views. I don't like to have more loans even for business unless it is required. What is requirement is the loan should not be used for receivables and stocks. That should be used for manufacturing process or working capital only, not for overburden of this one. So what I suggest is there every time there is scope for reducing the cost, improving the productivity, and any cost can be reduced. Every time there will be a scope for improvement and reducing the cost, wastage, damage, everything that is possible. It is only experts with their experience can give better advice, better suggestion to increase your profitability and also better performance to your organization. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Anybody wants to ask any further question or further information? I am finding a very big, interesting crowd. How SME analytics can help for planning succession? Sir, see, SME analytics can help you first to understand where do you stand from your balance sheet, analyzing and help you to see that you increase your operational efficiency. Succession planning is a long-term process, but we will be able to help you first. Where do you understand where do you stand? And then depending on your age and other things, how will you be able to grow your business to my first preference will be to encase the value unlocking by IPO. If your business is up to that level, we can help us to go to IPO. Otherwise also, how to increase operational efficiency of your existing operations by analyzing your balance sheet for last 3-4 years and guide you. And many of my friends all over India, they say the balance sheet of MSME is not true. Yes, about before GST and before demonetization, it was true. But now slowly that is changing. Your flexibilities of playing with your balance sheet is reducing. And if you pay more taxes or genuine taxes, it is for benefit of you. Anytime you can come for to us for help, your succession planning. Any further questions? Somebody has asked, what exactly SMS work for? Where are you? Whether you are a consultant, can you please tell about your company? Thanks, Manjula. Yes, see, SME Analytics is a offshoot of Growth Idea Lab. And Growth Idea Lab was working for revival of Sikh MSME unit, where I was thinking of correcting a debt equity ratio by equity infusion, though I have reasonably failed. But I have written a book on that. And then when I realized in my 39 years of entrepreneurship, I was not able to understand. I used to go to chartered accountant at the end of the year to help me to reduce the tax and go with the same balance sheet. I used to go to bank and asking more money. So money was attracting me. I was not knowing the connection between debt equity and reducing the tax. So last 7-8 years, I am advocating strongly, look to your debt equity ratio, your other ratios, increase your operational efficiency, and use borrowed funds and other things only to keep that growing. Don't borrow, as again Hanumantu Sir has said also, that borrowing is a poison if it's not taken in a proper dosage. If you take overdose, the death is there. What is the meaning of SME analytics? See, SMEA analytics was SME and analytics we wanted to start, but we did not get the SMEA analytics name. So we took that A here and started SMEA analytics. So we want to help. Our vision is to get 1 lakh balance sheet free for analyzing in this year and go up to 20 lakhs in 5 years. So we are trying to engage 10 marketing boys who will go to MSME unit and explain about the product. So anybody can help us for getting good marketing boys that will help the MSME around. Last year we did similar project in Uppal area, and we found, and same thing we did about 2 years back in Vizag. So there is no change in attitude of entrepreneur, because they feel successful entrepreneur says that I've done something right, so I don't have to improve. And failed entrepreneur goes to n number of consultant and dies. That is what is a general picture which I can say. Because he stick to one consultant and understand the benefits of his advice. Don't leave them in half the way. Otherwise, you are going to be sufferers. But this is my personal opinion. Somebody is asking, what is the book name? Is it possible to put the name? It is Unexplored Gold Mine. The name of the book is Unexplored Gold Mine. Opportunities on revival of Sikh MSME unit. There's a tremendous opportunity when you revive a Sikh unit by correcting a debt and equity ratio. but this webinar is not for that purpose. So we'll restrict to that this thing. So any further questions? Somebody is asking. The unexplored gold mine. They have put that name of the book. So if there is nothing much, we can end the webinar. Next webinar will be on 24th, and it will be on the subject of production link incentive schemes. Government has come out with 2.5 lakh to 3 lakh crores incentive for production link incentive for larger units in 13 sectors. And there is a big opportunity for MSME to grab that, supplying the components, supplying various items which these industries are going to require, but it requires a change in mindset. My personal opinion, when Maruti started a production and they have developed an ecosystem of automobile ancillary, in last 25 years, last 5-7 years, we have become one of the world leaders for automobile components. That has happened because they brought that managerial technologies and other things. The other benefit is, at that time when Maruti came, Hindustan Motor and Fiat and standard kind of cars were there. Today, at every 15,000 rupees change in the price, you can get a better model. It starts from 4 lakhs to maybe 4 crores. So that has come because that liberalization by Sri Narasimha Rao ji, as well as a continuous effort by entrepreneurs, young and mature, to take this opportunity. So I think next webinar, third webinar on 31st, will be on prepack insolvency for MSME. On 4th April 2021, government has come out with a little relaxed guidelines for a corporate MSME borrower so that they can take advantage on this thing. I think some people are saying thanks. Thank you, sir. Sarkar ji, valuation, IPO trust, trusted benefit everyone. Thank you, Sarkar sir. Can we now see you on next Saturday at 4 o'clock and propagate this to this, because PLI scheme, a good number of people also are not able to understand and connect what is useful to you. Thank you. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel and help me to get 10 marketing boys who are there in around your knowledge. Thank you.